Hold on to me as we go, as we roll down this unfamiliar road. And although this wave is stringing us along, just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home.
Good morning, today is Tuesday, February 2nd. My name is Zakoi. Welcome to the morning news. Happy birthday to Kobe, Hernandez, Miranda, and Madeline Smith. Have a super day. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
February is Black History Month, so every day this month we will have two students presenting from 6th or 7th grade their research projects on an important African American in our history. Please enjoy.
Queen Latifah was born on March 18, 1970 in Newark, New Jersey. She went to Irvington Frank H. High School and went to Delaware State University. She got a degree in honorary degree. She is an actor, singer, producer. Her real name is Dana Elena Owens. They call her Queen Latifah because when she was 8 years old, a Muslim cousin gave her the nickname of Queen Latifah, which means delicate and sensitive in Arabic. After Queen Latifah finished school, she started her acting career. First, Latifah made her big screen debut in Spy Interricolo romance drama Jungle Fever in 1991. And the following year, she appeared in the crime thriller Juice with Omar Epps and Tupa C. Sharka. Latifah soon landed a leading role on the small screen in the sitcom Living Single from 1993 to 1998. Right now, Queen Latifah is not working on anything new, but is living in Kaltenick, New Jersey.
Jay-Z is a very important African-American hip-hop legend. He was born as Sean Corey Carter on December 4th, 1969. He was raised mostly by his mother in an often dangerous housing project just outside of Brooklyn. While growing up, he was sadly exposed to drugs, violence, and gangs. However, these events would later shape his musical career. He attended two different high schools, but he actually never graduated or received a degree. He eventually, as a young adult, sadly fell into an addiction and started selling drugs. But during this time, he learned to have a big passion with music. So in the late 80s, he became a rapper under the name Jazzy. However, he would later shorten this to Jay-Z, which is what we all know him as today. In 1994, he was featured on a first actual album called Daddy's Home in 1994. But 2 years later, he came up with his first debut album in 1996 called Reasonable Doubt. Yet, he still didn't have a full-time job. He wasn't making enough money, so he started selling CDs out of his car. Now, during this time, it was when him and a couple of other friends formed Rockefeller Records label after selling CDs in their car. Jay-Z continued to grow in increasingly popularity throughout the late 90s. Yet in 1999, he was accused of murder and was sent to jail. He paid to get out of jail as soon as he was sent in, but eventually he would recover from his issues and get back to rapping. On April 4th, 2008, Jay-Z married the famous pop singer Beyoncé. Today, Jay-Z is a businessman, rapper, and has won 22 Grammy Awards. He is almost a billionaire and is 51 years old. He lives with Beyoncé in a very rich apartment in New Jersey. Jay-Z will always be remembered as an important figure in African-American culture.
Picture Day is Thursday. Virtual students are encouraged to come to BMS to get their pictures taken at lunch and during IoT Smile Pretty.
Hey, homeroom teachers, we have a challenge for you. See if you can motivate your students to bring in the most cans.
You can even set a goal for them to reach. Start with 25 cans this week, or you can do one per student. It's up to you.
Here are the prizes for the homerooms that bring the most cans. First place, we have candy and dress down day. Second place, we have frozen treats. And third place, we have candy. Don't they sound great? Keep bringing in those cans!
Baseball and softball tryouts start this Tuesday after school. Boys soccer tryouts start Wednesday, February 3rd after school.
Girls soccer will meet in C1 after dismissal tomorrow, Wednesday, February 3rd. And please make sure you bring your athletic clothes. Track tryouts will be Monday, February 8th.
To participate, a student must have a district packet and a COVID-19 waiver form to completed. If a student played a sport this school year or tried out for a sport, they do not need a new packet.
All right, some new books came in last week on Friday. I just want to let you know about them. Here's a new book by Tiffany Jackson, who wrote Monday's Not Coming. It's grown. It's kind of an intense book. A lot of the books that came in are teen books. Here's another one of Jacqueline Woodson's books. She writes in narrative verse, which makes them short and great. A lot of great stories here. This one looks really interesting, Pet. And this one, I know everyone will be excited. It's called Dear Justice, kind of the sequel to Dear Martin. So if some of you Dear Martin fans come, I got two copies of this one. This is another narrative verse book, kind of an intense book called The Opposite of Innocent. And this is highly acclaimed. I haven't read these books. They're brand new. You Should See Me in a Crown. It's supposed to be wonderful. Oprah's book pick. The Black Flamingo is supposed to be great. And a sequel to New Kid, the graphic novel. And I'm so excited to read this. It's called Class Act. I loved New Kid, so it should be good. Frankie in Love, King of the Dragonflies. Ooh, this one's going to be good. The Cousins. Some of y'all might remember the book, Two Can Keep a Secret and One of Us is Lying. This is by the same author and it's called Cousins. And then another awesome mystery called The Naturals. I'm reading this right now and it is different than anything I've ever read and I'm really enjoying it. So anyway, come on down and check out these books.
It's time for the joke of the day.
What do you call a farmer that makes bad jokes?
I don't know.
Corny.
Have a terrific Tuesday. Thanks for watching.
Oh, it'll all be clear.
Okay,
wait.